Good morning and welcome to this webinar of admissions 2016 to Symbiosis Law School Pune. I have the great pleasure of meeting you all and hoping to satisfy your queries with the esteemed panel that I have with me. I am Dr. Shashikala Gurpur. As I make the presentation, you will know a little bit about me in addition to what you would have already searched for. On my right, I've got our Deputy Director, Dr. Bindu Ronald, and to her right, we have Dr. Shashikant Hazare, followed by Dr. Mrs. Surya Rashmi Rawat, Dr. Mrs. Rupal Rao Desai, and our younger faculty, Dr. Atmaram Shelke, who is also monitoring the admission. On my left, I've got Professor Parameshwaran, followed by a representative from the parent community, who is a corporate leader, Mr. Niranjan Sinha. Niranjan Sinha is the General Counsel of GE Capital India, followed by Dr. Aparajita Mohanty, our Associate Professor, Professor Sata Arya, our Assistant Professor. And we also have a very young faculty who had been our alumni till recently, who will give you the alumni as well as faculty perspectives on placement, Professor Munaz Ahmed. Thank you, panel, and I welcome each and every one of you. Now, before I begin the details in the verbose form, I would like you to take a look at a video presentation which have brought in as part of the presentation. Now, the surprise is for you because you are going to listen to somebody whose presence in Supreme Court would cost not less than 20 lakhs an hour. And this person is none other than legendary lawyer, Advocate Ram Jaitmalani. Advocate Ram Jaitmalani is Professor Emeritus of the Faculty of Law of Symbiosis International University, and as you know, he is one person who has a multifaceted personality from which our young students can draw inspiration as well as many lessons. Advocate Ram Jaitmalani is seen in this snapshot administering the Law Day Oath, which shows you that Symbiosis Law School is not just about churning out lawyers for the corporate sector of India, but also mostly about inculcating values, looking at law as a public service profession. I would like to commend you for making this choice of legal education for your child, because no one comes to law unless they have a deeper calling for justice. And deeper calling for justice has got a larger connection to democracy, to governance, to happiness, and to equality. So this is what you're going to see. I'm also happy to tell you, as I present this video, that on the video you will see our top leadership team, who are all standing there like little students. Means learning is a kind of DNA in Symbiosis International University. They are standing like students following the oath with Advocate Ram Jaitmalani. You would see there our Vice Chancellor, Mrs. Rajni Gupte, our Principal Director, Dr. Vidya Ravdekar, and most of all, the founder of Symbiosis and Chancellor of Symbiosis International University, Dr. S.B. Mazumdar, among others. Over to the video now.
Our first May as the date of celebration, we have more freedom, and we exercise that freedom by fixing a day which suits my principals and my professors and the faculty here and the students, of course. Now I will say this, and you please follow me and repeat what I say. That's the way I administer this oath. I take oath and thereby pledge that I shall at all times abide by the Constitution, respect its ideals and institutions, and uphold.
Thank you for your attention. Now let me take you through the details of what Symbiosis Law School is all about. I hope that through the presentation, some of the questions that may be lingering in your mind would be answered. As we propose, Symbiosis Law School Pune stands for classic excellence and leadership in Indian legal education. briefly, this is because this law school has been in existence much before the national law schools, with the mould of a national law school, with students drawn from across the country and based on merit-based entrance examination as well as very rigorous entrance system. Aside from that, it plays a leadership role in Indian legal education, not only in the region but also in the country, by inculcating best practices and best lawyering skills. The vision of the law school is to be among the global leaders of excellence in education as well as research of law through care, courage, competence and collaboration. These four C's are reflected in the way the genesis and the trajectory would come in front of you. As I already told you, it was created in 1977. In 1985, this inclusive, innovative, courageous experiment, which was responding to the felt need of Pune, which then had only one law school, stood as the experiment in excellence because it was the first one in the country, among the first three to offer 5-year law program. It also was one of the first few to enter the top 10 league in the country. By 2002, we were already there in the India Today Nielsen ranking, which began almost in 2000 for the law faculty. And consistently we have been standing among the top 5 in last 5 years. And this law school, among two other constituents, that is SABM, as you all know, and Symbiosis Institute of Computer Science and Research, SICSR, to become the first three constituents of deemed university. This status was conferred on Symbiosis group of institutes in 2002 because of the excellence, niche areas in which they were experimenting higher education, and because of the innovation. Now, consistently we have been ranked. This is the evidence. This slide shows you the snapshots from various ranking agencies and newspapers or magazines from where these rankings have been announced. Then my own profile as the person who is leading this institution and the team here is as follows. I have had a short stint in Bangalore National Law School in the early days of its formation in the mid-90s. Soon after that, I took up a job in Europe. Before entering the law school, I was in Mangalore teaching law for 5 years as a full-time faculty. My specialization has been international law. And as a student, I have been consistently among the top students of the various universities where I did my studies from. Now, research interests of mine are also varied, although focused in international law. Within that, it's very much in combination of technology and environmental law. And aside from that, the legal research agenda has been very strongly growing here because of my passion for research as well. Aside from that, we have kick-started various justice education initiatives through community legal service after 2007 that I took over, consolidating the existing initiatives. Some of my credentials you would see there. I have been part of the state system as a consultant and advisor in the Law Commission of India as a member, in the Judicial Academy currently continuing as a member, Curriculum Development Committee membership of the Bar Council of India, which looks at legal curriculum. And also on, we have an equivalence committee which looks at validating the foreign law degrees. I'm also the board member, who was the board member in the past, both in National Law School Hyderabad and in IGNO School of Law. I have been invited as a life member of Indian Law Institute, and we have been on the editorial teams of our own college journal, two flagship journals. One is the General Journal, which is a contemporary law journal, and the other is the Student Law Review, where students lead, and some of my faculty members are on the editorial board as well. Aside from that, I have been on the editorial boards of many international journals as well. And main focus is that, aside from all these curriculum and state experiments, I also have a very strong track record of publication. Right now it is 54, it is shown as 51 here. Along with that, 6 book chapters, 2 books now, and PhD guides to guide to many students. Now that's about it. Aside from that, some of the recently emerging national law schools have been assisted by me on their research and publication committee as well. Now that will assure you surely that you are in the safe hands of a leadership of the excellent team which is there in the law school. I have already told you the vision and mission of Symbiosis Law School is very much in consonance with the vision and mission of Symbiosis in toto. which is promoting international understanding through quality education and in creating global competencies and values and knowledge and thought-provoking leadership for the society. Now, landmarks of growth of SLS Pune at the expense of repetition, if I can draw your attention. 1985, we commenced five-year law program. 2012, we leapfrogged into research-centric law school by creating the Symbiosis Center for Advanced Research, and thereby we also institutionalized the one-year LLM program as one of the three law schools in the country, as well as our advanced research agenda. By 2014, we have spent more than a decade of consistent top five position, and there has also been the revival of the three-year program, which we had discontinued earlier. We have recast it in the seriousness of our five-year program as well. Now, at this juncture, I should mention, by 2014, we had under the Faculty of Law, under the stewardship of this law school's leadership team and faculty team, the third law school of Symbiosis evolving in Hyderabad. In 2010 itself, the Noida Law School evolved, and already it has a very firm position in legal education in the country. In 2016, I'm happy to share with you that the GHRDC Law School survey, which just announced its result, has put us in second rank in the category of leading super excellence law schools and first in the Western region. Now, all these kinds of ranking, etc., why do they happen? Why? What makes us stand out? I would broadly say that we have already been acknowledged by the accreditation body, namely the Bar Council of India in 2012 as a gold star. We were one of the six to receive this honor. Our international dimension is very clear in our evolution of Symbiosis itself. We have a curriculum which is cutting edge. We focus on pro bono, that is a kind of community service from the legal side, kind of activities as mandatory for all students through service learning initiatives. Now, as I have already told you, we look at all-round internationalization. We are the pioneers in five-year program with BBA LLB as one of the first few. We and the Jodhpur Law School were the first to offer that, and one-year LLM program, as I told you already. Our curriculum is comprehensive, and our student development is also comprehensive, well-structured in a progressive manner. Our research and publication have been visible at the national and global level. Some of the highlights, if I may show, the highlights of SLS Pune are twofold. One is Pune itself as an attraction, which shows how it's a place of pleasant weather, neither too cold nor too hot. It is the educational hub of India. It is a historical city. It's considered as one of the top cities as far as safety of women is concerned. Because of its low crime rate, it is also a safe city per se. Pune's music and food, especially the Sawai Gandharva festival and other modern fusion music festivals and get-togethers, are well known. The law school is only situated at a distance of 1.5 kilometers from the modern hub of Koregaon Park, etc. It's the eighth largest metropolitan economy in the country, and it is a cultural capital of Maharashtra, studded with museums, parks and zoos. SLS Pune per se, in this context, has proven excellence in undergraduate and postgraduate teaching, has innovative curriculum, is rich with techno-driven learning resources, student care and progress with the very well-structured placement initiative. It has focus on social agenda and ethics. Its leadership is present in internationalizing legal education. You know, legal education is one of the difficult fields to internationalize, but SLS Pune has got a strong record. I'll show you the glimpses as we progress. The reputation of the law school, I mean, which must have attracted all of you to listen to this webinar, the flexibility in learning and the versatile training that we offer to students, which prepares our students to a large number of diverse careers, I'll show you later on. Now, this is a picturesque presentation of the attractions which must make you choose Pune over others. The historical Shaniwar Wada, the location, I mean, you would see in the center the picture of our new campus, the entry, which is richly decorated by our students. The canteen of ours is what we call as the swanky canteen, designed in the style of Italian cafe. Our moot court hall is designed after the historical Tilak trial hall of Mumbai High Court. Our classrooms are also multimedia facilitated. Our learning is very strongly techno-driven. And the library has got very rich resources with an yearly investment of 1.25 crores. Now, coming to the program, you will be convinced that this is not just a good Indian law school, but a law school which can vie for world-class position. Some of the fact sheet glimpses show you the richness of the program, the diversity. We have upgraded our program into honors program, offering 25% of extra courses in either a specialization group or in a general set of courses as the student chooses. Now, this is the only law school in the Symbiosis family which is offering honors program. So, if you are one of those who wants to be intellectually challenged, then this is the place to go. We have side-by-side students can pursue a number of certificate programs, diploma programs. Then we run the capsule courses with the experts from legal field. Now, these are done either on 2 days at the weekend or on the weekend, that is on a Saturday. Student strength is also touching about 1,738 students we have, of which 71 students are LLM, 105 are 3-year LLB, and rest are 5-year law course students. Coming to research also, our publications have jumped in number. We have institutionalized the research through the SCALSAR. We have got the 2 journals which are published through the LexisNexis in years to come. That is after our first 3 volumes. The 3rd volume is due this year. Once the 3rd volume is released, we are not going to continue it as a journal of the institute, but the publications will come as special publications of the leading databases or publishers such as Elsevier. That is the next vision that we have seen. Now, coming to internationalization of legal education that I told you already about, the glimpses are like this. We have collaborations across almost all regions of the globe. Probably with Africa, we do not have collaboration, but we have students and we have people who are invited, and our alumni are already researching in one of the leading African universities in Johannesburg. We have membership in the international networks of justice education, legal education, Asian law school network, and conservation of nature, IUCN network as well. We have delegations of students from foreign universities coming here to pursue either a semester or a month-long program or a specially tailor-made program or customized program from Chuo University, Japan, Australia, Brunswick, Germany, Deakin University, and Flinders University of Australia. Student exchange programs are also very richly continued with the University of Hanover of Germany, Leibniz University. We have Australia University. From Ireland, we have got 2 universities with whom we have the collaboration. The photos will indicate to you how international we are in everything, right from the competition. This year, we mooted a very interesting competition called Criminal Trial Advocacy Competition, which was judged by, you would see there, the Irish law professor from Liverpool University, who sits as an advisor to the International Criminal Court. We have the British Council Western Region Chief here participating along with an academic delegation from United Kingdom's leading universities. Coming to our grand events, every year we run these events. One is the Law Day. The beginning of this presentation was done with a glimpse from the Law Day of Law Day Oath being administered by Advocate Ram Jethmalani. We have a student festival where students choose the theme and run this festival, whereby we also institutionalize the alternative dispute resolution tournament, sports, dance, music, fashion show, etc. We had, as I already told you, the International Criminal Trial Advocacy Moot, which was witnessed and participated by 6 international teams. Every year we run the alumni meet, which acts as a sustenance and support, creating buddies and creating contacts for placement, for training our students for global moots, and also all-round excellence, because alumni act as mentors also. We have annual research conference, which we hold in the month of September every year. This year's was the 4th edition. We have the B.G. Deshmukh Memorial Lecture, which is a public lecture, which we conduct with a non-governmental organization which fights against corruption, the Public Concern for Governance Trust, which was created by the then Cabinet Secretary, who is no more, late B.G. Deshmukh. Nani Palkhiwala Memorial Elocution Contest is held by us. It is held for the 8th time. We have drawn participants from all the law schools from Pune, and then we decide the best speaker. We have a strong tie-up with Surana and Surana law firm, which conducts the Moot Premier League competition on international technology law, which saw its 14th edition this year. Now, aside from that, our teaching learning practices, the pedagogic practices, are entirely student-centric. We not only handhold students, but we also encourage self-learning initiative in students. You would see the list of cutting-edge practices in our pedagogic list, which has right from student presentation to group discussion to round-robin quizzes, writing research papers, small group learning, and so on. One most important feature you see at the end of the list, and that is the most important feature, every student, whether shy or outgoing, does minimum 5 moots in the life cycle in Symbiosis Law School and 2 mock trials. Mock trials are run by students to understand the procedural law. This year we started a very interesting simulation called the boardroom simulation, whereby students get training to behave like directors and how to behave in a boardroom and how the law is applied in the boardroom discourses. Now, teaching is also responding to the felt need of the time and prepares students for all-round kind of excellence, as you would see on the right-hand side in the list. We have the International Law Students Association SLS Pune chapter, which looks at international programs. Most of these details my colleagues will tell you when their turn comes. Aside from that, we have many innovative and best practices which you would see in the leading institutes of the country, whether it is law school or management school or IIT. Some of the soft skills which are prescribed by Government of India are also already captured in our institutionalized practices. Aside from that, we have systems which take 100% care of students, not only in their crisis but also in their excellence. Now, coming to our faculty diversity, you would be very happy to see that 50% of faculty has had some or other kind of international exposure. Exposure is not just as a tourist, but going there and teaching courses. Because of that, the learning experience is very much of a joyful and challenging experience for students, because the faculty bring such experience to their classes in the form of methodology and content. We have some of our faculty, I have Dr. Rupal here, who are qualified patent attorneys. So you will have a lot of innovation-related edge in teaching. One faculty, that is Professor Arya, is a polyglot. She is an expert in 3 European languages. Of course, in Spanish, she holds a master's as well. I have Professor Rawat on this panel, who is a management expert and a law degree holder. We also have a faculty who is a journalist who is assisting us in terms of community legal service by strategizing our approach. I myself am a Fulbrighter. Dr. Bindu has had the experience of going as European Union scholarship scholar in Germany. So this is how we have enriched our faculty competence. In terms of student diversity, you would see a large percentage of students coming from the north and central region. There's a small percentage coming from northeast as well. Southern states have contributed. Maharashtra itself has contributed a large number of students as well. And there is a chunk of students who come from abroad, people of Indian origin, and a small percentage comes from foreign countries as foreign nationals. India impact of SLS Pune is evident in this small snippet, which shows various media reflections on the kind of discourses that SLS Pune has generated in the national scenario. Coming to our awards and recognition, as the institute we have received award. As people also, our people have received various awards to go abroad, teach, participate in conferences because of their intellectual contribution. Student achievements, as you would see here, you will be glad to see one of your awards to be such awardees in future. Our team qualified to the global round of environmental law moot, the Stetson Law Moot, which is a prestigious moot. We have consistently been among the top 10 in the Moot Premier League, which is a kind of league which is created out of thousands of law schools which participate in moot competition. We have repeatedly have had the honorable mention among 150 teams in the world in the Viz moot, Viz arbitration moot. We have had national representation in the Philip Jessop moot. We have been winners in the national mock trial competition, in the multiple legal skill competitions, whether it is counseling, whether it is taxation moot or other number of moots. Now, we have a very strong industry collaboration. In the legal parlance, industry is not only corporates and manufacturing sector, it is also about legal industry, which has got the law firms, which has got the counseling divisions of various corporates. You would see here how the industry contributes to us on the left-hand side. As you would see, we organize competitions through them. We have workshops on emerging areas. We run capsule courses. Recently, we had a capsule course on shipping with the collaboration of Bose and Mitra, the leading shipping lawyers in the country. We run guest lectures through them. They come and impart drafting courses. We take students for a judgment writing training to the Maharashtra Judicial Academy. A lot of judges also come here and engage classes. Industry training is imparted through visits. Civil service exams orientation is institutionalized. On the right hand side, you would see some of our collaborators whom we pull in to give courses, and we also go there as faculty and give consulting. Now coming to placements, you would see here on the left hand side in red letters all those star employers of ours, including PricewaterhouseCoopers, Khaitan, Amarchand Mangaldas, etc. On the right hand side, you would see the percentages of placement share. Large chunk is taken by law firms, which means we train our students not as just corporate competent, but as competent to litigation and to multiple law skills. Companies, individual practice is also sought after. There's a big 9% who choose to litigate, and higher education is also very closely competing with that, about 6%. Our highest package has touched about 15 lakhs a year, and average package goes at 5 lakhs a year. Now these are some of the snapshots of our community engagement. We contribute to national agenda, we also contribute to the local community, and thereby it's a mutual learning. Students learn, students develop a commitment for community service. It is not just about looking at packages. That is why it's contrasting with the slide on placement. Now coming to impact of SLS Pune on the students, you know, how is our product? You will see in these two narrations how our students have excelled. One is the narration from our master's, I mean our undergraduate student, who later got selected as the judge in Meghalaya. I have got a number of star alumni, but I am only quoting these quotes for want of time. We have had the other one who went to King's College London for his master's, and currently he is in the competition team of Vinod Dhal and Associates. See how he says that it provided me excellent opportunity to become a well-rounded lawyer and human being. That's most important, because many times they say lawyer or human being. So that's why this statement is also important. Now, aside from this, we have got alumni who have been stars, who have been corporate legal team leaders, who have finished IAS. One of them is working in Madhya Pradesh. The recently qualified lady student Shatrupa has been Indian Revenue Service candidate, and she's trying to civil service again. And then we have created host of judges like Justice Revati, Mohit Dere, and Sadhna Zada, who are the sitting High Court judges in Mumbai, and large number of judicial officers in Maharashtra, number of bureaucrats in Africa in our older batches, pre-2002 batches. So there's a very strong alumni body that we have who come and help us in every walk of life. So we thank you for choosing us, and we welcome you to join us and be a part of the glorious saga. Thank you. Now I invite my colleague, Dr. Bindu Ronald, who is not only assisting me in the overall administration of the institute, but also will be reflecting with you the curriculum, teaching, assessment, best practices, and how we are forward-looking and corporate savvy. Incidentally, Bindu is also our alumnus. Over to you, Dr. Bindu.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm Dr. Bindu Ronald, Deputy Director and Professor at Symbiosis Law School, Pune, and I welcome all viewers to this webinar, where you can get a brief insight into what Symbiosis Law School is about. My association with Symbiosis began when I joined Symbiosis as a student of the five-year law program in the late 80s, and as a student, I chose Symbiosis for its cosmopolitan environment and international exposure, yet maintaining the academic rigors. Even when I decided to move after a few years of teaching at one of the top national law schools in 2007, I knew it had to be Symbiosis. I speak today in the capacity of an alumni, a professor, and deputy director, proud to be associated with this institution, which is known for the quality education that it imparts. I've never regretted my decision, whether it was joining Symbiosis as a student in the late 80s or coming back to the law school to be on the other side of the table. The alumni of Symbiosis Law School, Pune, occupy top positions in different areas, such as top law firms as partners and associates, in corporate houses as in-house counsels, judiciary, ministry, civil service, academia, etc., And our alumni have led succeeding generations of students, holding their hand and guiding them. It is an institution where the alumni feel proud to reassociate with and come back and give something to the alma mater. Many of our alumni have come back to us as industry mentors, trainers, and helped in MOOC trainings, delivering special lectures, etc. Among the top law schools of the country, Symbiosis Law School Pune is the preferred destination for law studies for various reasons. One of the first to introduce the 5-year law program, we are open to making changes when required, ensuring quality parameters in legal education comparable to the best in the world. We are one of the very few institutions in the country offering BBA LLB program as well as BA LLB program, and since 2014 we offer BBA LLB and BA LLB honors program. We were one of the first to offer the 1-year LLM program in 2013 when the UGC permitted the 1-year program. And giving in to constant demand, we have reintroduced the 3-year LLB program. Our value-added courses give an edge to the students. There are about 17 diploma programs and 19 certificate programs which we offer at the law school, and the students can pursue these diplomas and certificate programs along with their academic schedule. The law school is student-centric and has various student-centric activities such as the buddy system, mentoring, remedial programs for students requiring personal coaching on a one-to-one basis. Our new batch of students are handheld and introduced to Symbiosis Law School through a very well-planned induction program where they are introduced to the law school system, to the library, to various learning resources, and to student-centric activities such as the student cells. Symbiosis Law School pays detailed attention to curriculum development, and curriculum audits are conducted both at the institution level as well as at Symbiosis International University level. We take regular feedbacks from our stakeholders, and these stakeholders, students, industry, etc., contribute to the curriculum planning and development. Students are exposed to adequacy and drafting skills from the very beginning, and we have international faculty from top US universities who give month-long training programs on mooting and trial advocacy right in the first semester itself. We believe in experiential learning, and students are taken to forensic science labs, courts, and judicial academy where the experts talk to them and they observe the proceedings there. We train our students for various competitive exams, and the law school organizes various workshops, seminars, capsule courses, and workshops. And they are held on various contemporary issues, and they expose the students to renowned experts from various fields. We adopt an interdisciplinary approach to courses with emphasis on human rights aspects, international dimensions, and social dimensions in teaching. Ethics and ethical practices training have been made part of the curriculum. The college adopts innovative teaching methods, which includes MOOCs, mock trials, role plays, movies, theater, group exercises, in addition to the regular classroom lectures. Our initiatives and soft skill development programs make our students corporate savvy. Our recent introduction of the students to the boardroom meetings was through a theater-based boardroom stimulation exercise. The academic calendar prepared before the beginning of the semester ensures goal-oriented events and activities. We have been at the forefront, whether it is curricular, co-curricular, or extracurricular aspects, and match international and global practices. We believe in creating world-class lawyers with passion, compassion, and ethical values, and we create the leaders of tomorrow. Symbiosis Law School is a success story. I welcome you to join us and be part of it. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bindu. Now I request Dr. Parameshwaran to highlight some of the international dimensions in the curriculum teaching and the culture of SLS Pune.
Thank you, madam. Greetings to all the students from Symbiosis Law School Pune. One of the important reasons for the success of Symbiosis Law School, Pune, is the concentration that is being given to international law studies. The concentration that is given to the international dimensions in teaching comprises of four major aspects. They are the teaching of public international law as a subject, two, the global perspectives that a student ought to develop in every angle of law, three, a comparative law understanding across different jurisdictions, and four, sustainable development as a focus that ought to be brought in every legal knowledge. The concentration that we give to these four major dimensions, which we call it as the international law dimensions in curriculum and academics, and the culture as such in the Symbiosis Law School, Pune, is spread across teaching, research guidance, the courses that are conducted, the sheer diversity of international culture that are present here, and the students' participation. If I can put in a nutshell how we do that kind of concentration in all these areas, in terms of teaching for both UG and PG as well as the doctoral studies, all the students are asked to look for the international dimension in every subject they look for and they study and they understand. There is not a single subject that is left where international law dimension or a global perspective or sustainable development perspective or a comparative law perspective or a foreign jurisdiction perspective which should be looked into. In terms of PG teaching, this kind of international law dimension is thrusted upon more so that when they qualify for the master's degree, their emergence into the international career outside gets more stabilized and strong. When it comes to research guidance, where international law dimensions are to be brought forth, the major thrust is whatever articles that students write, which we promote a lot, and whatever projects that they do as a part of the continuous evaluation or periodical submissions that they do for the evaluations or the case analysis or the projects that they do, the international law dimension is always thrusted upon. Whatever be the subject, whatever be the research, whatever be the hypothesis that they take for any kind of research angle, international law dimension is thrusted upon, where a global perspective and a sustainable development view and a cross-country or a cross-jurisdictional issues are brought forth through comparative angles. When it comes to higher education, which students are interested in, when they finish the masters or after the bachelor's, when they go for masters in different countries, we always give the focus for the international law dimensions and we request the students to concentrate on that. And when it comes to mooting, which is also a growing phenomenon among all law schools throughout the country and even the world, the public international law dimension is always taken care of. And when it comes to SCLJ, which is the Symbiosis Contemporary Law Journal, and SSLR, these two prime journals of the Symbiosis Law School, the articles which various authors submit and the students submit, we look for an international law dimension, a comparative law perspective, a global law view, and a sustainable development focus. These four aspects are continuously thrusted upon. And finally, the courses that the Symbiosis conducts as a capsule course or a certificate course, you can see the international flavor in that. But how do we do these all these major things where the concentration is added? The faculties are there to guide all the students, be it UG and PG, and we have with us our professor and the director of the law school, who is an international law expert. And under her guidance, many things on international law dimensions are explored upon. And students are in turn asked to participate and proactively work on these kind of dimensions. These are all the things which we do, in which we bring the international dimensions so that the Symbiosis Law School is not just national-centric, but also international-centric. When it comes to a career which a student would obviously be interested upon, how do we look at it and how international law dimension can be of a great help for a student, both UG, PG and the doctoral student? One is the government jobs which we help the student to apply for, and then we encourage by giving the recommendation letter, reference, and helping them in writing the SOPs and so on. They have an ample opportunity for NGOs in human rights, environment. Then they have opportunities in treaty division, legal entities of Ministry of External Affairs, where students' internships are taken, and we encourage students to participate in that so that they come to know how international laws are drafted. Then when it comes to foreign affairs, internships are promoted and developmental work across country and the world outside, and many government departments which are now looking for students to contribute something from the international angle, especially the comparative angle. There are some students who will be interested in going for UN jobs. There are so many that are there available now, and with the help of database that are there and the information highway which we have right now, the United Nations Volunteer, UNV, the United Nations Peacekeeping Force, then international governmental organizations, the developmental work, the human rights, environment, sustainable development, and many more. And all the specialized agencies of the United Nations, they throw lot of internship which may culminate into jobs and career, a successful career for a student, is also being encouraged, and they are asked to take upon if they have a bent and a drive towards international understanding. And there is a specific set of jobs in international organizations, especially ICJ, International Tribunals, WTO and WIPO, where students can also enroll for certain courses, certificate courses online, and they are also promoted for that, and we are very generous in appreciating the students who take it by giving the SOPs and so on. Then there comes the last and the most important one, which a student must be interested. If they are interested in litigation, litigating in the court as a lawyer, there are a lot of scopes, especially in India right now, where international flavor is included. There is not even a single document or a law paper which is devoid of international content, especially the choice of law class and the choice of jurisdiction class, which comes as a separate subject called private international law, which Symbiosis Law School is going to introduce from the next year onwards, and we are probing on that. So these are the various ways in which international law is thrusted upon, and the comparative law studies is being appreciated, and global perspectives are asked to develop, and then they can work on various fields where international dimensions can be stretched, and they can go ahead for a successful career. Finally, if I can say, as a teacher of international law, with India emerging and the current government which is interested in promoting internationalization of India, both inside and outside, and the flow of FDI which is increasing, and the international trade, and the WTO and WIPO participating in international conventions where Indian participation is very much appreciated, there is so much to be done, and there is so much scope for students who take up international law, international dimensions, any kind of international understanding and trust and documentation and thinking and knowledge developed on these lines are very highly appreciated. And Symbiosis Law School, Pune, as such, with the team of faculties, they always focus on these issues, and we immediately give maximum appreciation and interest for students to take these things. So these are the things, and more can be brought out later, as and when people can also contact me if they want to know more about the international trust. Thank you, madam.
Now I request Professor Sujata Arya to give aspects of internationalization in SLS Pune.
Arya, and each of the faculty member at SLS Pune look after different cells. So the international cell is looked after by my senior colleague, Dr. Aparajita Mohanty ma'am, myself, and two new faculty members, Professor Aditya Kedari and Professor Ritambra Das. As ma'am has already mentioned, internationalization takes a center stage in the academic teaching and learning environment at Symbiosis Law School Pune, and this is in consonance with the vision of the Symbiosis International University to build world-class institutes honing the students to be global citizens and increasing global visibility. At the international cell, under the guidance of a director ma'am, we have various initiatives like the Scholar in Residence program, the Visiting International Faculty program, faculty and student mobility, semester exchange programs, delegation visits, facilitation of students' participation in different summer schools, international internships, membership of the prestigious international bodies which promotes a culture of research, participation in international conferences, and all these activities strengthen the process of internationalization. Every year we invite a US faculty who takes legal writing and research skills. So we develop a moot court problem and the students are divided into two sides, so either the plaintiff or the defendant, and they go through a whole rigorous process for 1 month, and each student is given individual feedback. Till date we've had Professor Bethany Hansen, we've had Professor Rebecca Todd, who's come from Antioch University, we've had Professor Tonya Kowalski from Washburn University, and this year again we will be inviting a US faculty member in the month of July or August, and this ensures that our moot students are among the top mooting teams in the country. Apart from this, our students, we have a detailed work plan for each of the visiting faculty members, and thus they undertake teaching at the UG and at the PG level. They undertake research, and also that the students can go and meet the faculty members if they want to discuss any of their research agendas. Apart from that, we also have the ILSA chapter at Symbiosis Law School, Pune, through which we align our extra and co-curricular activities, and we also conduct a Juristas International Law Essay Competition, basically on the topics of international law. We also conduct various activities under the ILSA chapter, and apart from that, we also have the Model United Nations simulation programs, through which the students get a feel of the international organizations, the working of international relations, and also debate and discuss on the contemporary issues which are there. Although we are constrained by the Bar Council regulations, many of our students have been able to get the benefit of student exchange either through short study trips or through semester exchange programs. And we also have a policy where the students may be able to take in the credits which they receive from foreign universities into their curricula. The concept of internationalization has also percolated into the academic curricula, as each of our courses has been enriched with topics of international law. This is what I would just like to highlight. There is many more things, but the students can further ask questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Arya. Now I would request on my right, Professor Hazare, who is our professor. Dr. Shashikant Hazare has been here for very long, and he is one of the most popular teachers of constitutional law. I request him to highlight on our co-curricular activity, mainly the mock trial and moot competitions. Over to you, Professor.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon. I am Dr. Shashikant Hazare. I am a professor at Symbiosis Law School, Pune. I have been associated with this institute for the last 13 years, and I am also faculty in charge of the post-graduation LLM program and the Law Hawks Community College. As a senior member of the faculty, I can assure you of the fact that we at Symbiosis Law School Pune create knowledgeable, skilled, ethical and employable law graduates, and we also prepare them for the challenges posed by the highly globalized and competitive world. We give a lot of emphasis on skill building through simulation exercises like moot courts and mock trials to train the students in the lawyering skills. The Moot Court Association of Symbiosis Law School Pune, which is popularly called as MCA, coordinates all the mooting activities in the college, and it also conducts orientation and training sessions for inculcating the advocacy skills among the students' community. The association is a team of few handpicked, dedicated and academically sound students with great leadership skills, and it is led by a very competent and experienced faculty members like Dr. Atmaram Shelke, my colleague who is sitting here, and Professor Shirish Kulkarni. The Moot Court Association also organizes internal elimination rounds for the purpose of creating a pool of students with the best of the mooting talents. And out of this pool, we send the students to represent SLS Pune in various international and national moot court competitions. We ensure that each team representing the college is very well trained and guided by the faculty members who have the expertise in the relevant areas of law, we also make sure that the mentoring is done by the senior students who have already established themselves as the mooters through success in various moot competitions. Our students have won many laurels for the college in many national and international moot competitions. I am pleased to inform you that recently our team has been qualified for the world rounds of the prestigious States and International Environmental Law Moot Court competition. And our teams have won first prize in many recent moot court competitions held in academic year 2015 and 16, including Nani Palkiwala Tax Moot, Justice B.P. Saraf Tax Moot, Irma Environmental Law Moot, Indraprasth National Moot, BACL Nagpur Moot, Barrister Advani Memorial Moot, MPLC National Moot, Dr. Anna Saheb Bendayan Memorial Moot, P. Apte Memorial Mock Trial, EMS Bangalore National Moot, MKES Moot, Oro National University Moot, Ramayya Memorial National Moot, and we have also won second prize Memorial Best Speakers in so many other competitions. Our law school has been ranked in one of the top ranked law colleges in India in the Putting Premier League, as Madam has already mentioned, MPL, and our current ranking is 11. And last month, we organized the first of its kind in India, International Criminal Mock Trial Advocacy Competition, which 18 top law schools in the country participated, along with 5 international teams. We had teams coming from Sussex University in UK and Kuwait, and we were fortunate to have as judges in the final round former Chief Justice of Sri Lanka, Justice Mohan Perez, and Dr. Anna Marie Brennan, who is the consultant in the trial chamber of the International Criminal Court at Hague, Netherlands. We have also in our college the Law Hawks Forum, which is a platform for bringing various groups together to share ideas on various topics which are related to culture, creativity, and multidimensional thinking. It also organizes annual book review competition, annual creative week to promote literary and cultural discourse amongst the students, and also Nani Palkiwala Memorial Elocution Competition, which Dr. Gurpur Madam has already mentioned. This year, the forum will be organizing a national quiz on constitutional law and history as a regional partner of the Center for Law and Policy Research for the Western Zone in the month of July. As a constitutional law teacher, I can proudly say that at SLS Pune, we give a lot of emphasis on public law and governance-related issues. As Madam has already mentioned, we organize annually Justice Y.V. Chandrachud Memorial Public Lecture every year. And we have invited in the past legal luminaries like Advocate Ram Jethmalani, Professor Upendra Bakshi, Justice Radhakrishnan, Justice C.K. Thakkar, and Central Information Commissioner M. Sridhar, etc. We also organize late Shri B.G. Deshmukh Memorial Lecture in the memory of the former Cabinet Secretary, Shri B.G. Deshmukh, who has been associated with Symbiosis for a long time. In association with PCGT, it is an NGO, Public Concern for Governance Trust, and we highlight the challenges which are faced by the governance in India. And we had eminent speakers for this series like Mr. Ujjwal Chaudhary, Dr. Ajit Ranade, Mr. Madhav Godbole. Then we also offer 1 year LLM program with 7 specializations in business and corporate law, constitutional and administrative law, innovation, technology, and intellectual property right, legal pedagogy, legal practice research, and criminal law and security law, human rights law, and legal practice and court management. We give a lot of emphasis on interdisciplinary approach and research orientation in the postgraduate programs, and the student has the option of cafeteria approach in terms of specialization. Thank you. Over to Dr. Gurpur, ma'am.
Thank you, Dr. Hazare. I request Dr. Aparajita Mohanty, our associate professor, to highlight the interdisciplinary angle in our curriculum, please.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good afternoon to you all. Taking further the discussion on BA LLB program, I would like to start with the oft-repeated quote that a lawyer should be like an architect as well as like a mason. Like a mason, he should know the technicalities, intricacies of laws, and like an architect, he must have an overall knowledge of the social, political, economic basis of the society and the issues confronting it. Because law doesn't operate in a vacuum, it operates in the society, which has again very complex undertones. The humanity courses under BALLB range from traditional courses like history, political science, economics, sociology, to relatively new courses like public administration, international relations, and issues regarding global politics. The courses provide to the students a very valid and broad knowledge base, and they are taught with a different orientation altogether. For example, history for a student of BALLB is not a mere chronicle of days, dates and events. Rather, it is a vivid account of the evolution of social, political and legal structure at any specific period of time. Similarly, public administration, apart from dealing with administrative theories, administrative concepts, also initiates the students to the niche area of understanding policy making as well as policy analysis. Here I would also like to point out that Symbiosis Law School Pune has a parliamentary debate and model parliament association, which acts as a very interesting forum for students to carry out discussion on various policy areas confronting the policy areas of the government, both nationally as well as internationally. Apart from the pedagogy of the humanities courses taught under BALLB, learning also happens through a variety of assessment methods like simulation of Model United Nations for course of international relations, where the students get an opportunity to test their knowledge of international relations, international law, diplomacy, negotiation skills, and apply it in a simulation of international organizations and try to further the national interests of the countries that they represent. Symbiosis Law School Pune also strives to build up the overall personality of the students by providing them with a forum for channelizing their talents. One such example is the law theater. Every year, the students stage a play with a theme of historical, political, and legal importance. Tilak trial, Merchant of Venice, Nanavati trial, to name a few, and the latest being the Great Trial, which depicted Gandhi's trial post non-cooperation movement. The aim of such theatre is to help the students to appreciate the nuances of law, the situation in which it operates, and also develop the argumentative skills. In all, it is a wonderful form of educating the students through meaningful entertainment. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mohanty. Now, in the similar vein, on management, discipline, and other quality compliance issues, I request our Associate Professor, Dr. Surya Rashmi Rawat, to address.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm Dr. Surya Rashmi Rawat, and I've been associated with SLS Pune for the last 5.5 years. I'm Professor in Charge, IQAC Cell, SLS Pune, Professor in Charge, Corporate Law Cell, Professor in Charge, Internal Examinations, and Editor, Lexet, the half-yearly newsletter of college. I'm a business management professor with MBA specialization in international business, and my PhD is in green marketing. At Symbiosis, I teach business management subjects to the BBA LLB students. BBA LLB is a 5-year program where students get an opportunity to study the business management subjects along with Symbiosis International University is one of the pioneers in introducing BBA LLB program. It started this integrated law program in the year 2003, and in the year 2014 introduced another BBA LLB honors program. This program aims to create a brand new race of corporate lawyers who would not only understand the intricacies of business but be equally well versed in the nuances of corporate law and regulatory affairs. The students here gain valuable insights in both the business functions like human resource management, marketing, and the corporate laws in the fields of banking, corporate governance, investment, competition, insurance, mergers and acquisitions. In addition to litigation, civil services, judicial services, corporate law firms, this dual degree also opens avenues for students to opt for different PG courses if they decide not to have a career in law. For example, if a student wants to have a career in management and wants to go in for MBA, he may do so. Along with the course curriculum, the teaching pedagogy, including lecture seminar method, group discussion, role play, presentations, case study method, capsule courses, workshops, and other team building and skill building exercises, ensure that the students are well prepared to face the world at the end of fourth year itself, as that is the time when campus placement process is kick-started for the batch which is all set to step into the final year of program. As part of internal evaluation, which accounts for 40% of the total evaluation, the BPA LLB students are taught to write management research papers and case studies. Students are thereafter guided and also encouraged to present and publish these research papers and case studies in different national and international conferences and journals. I may say that my students don't just read what is already published, rather they create knowledge, publish it, and thereafter ensure that the world reads it. In their first year itself, our students become authors of research papers published in the quality journals, which not only bear ISSN, but also are peer-reviewed and indexed. I may inform you that Symbiosis International University has been re-accredited with Grade A by NAC this year. The secret behind it is our commitment to set up high goals and then chase them honestly through our sincere efforts. For translating our aspirations to reality, we have IQAC, the Internal Quality Assurance Cell, created as per the NAC guidelines. The basic objective behind it is to develop a system of conscious, consistent, and catalytic action to improve the academic and administrative performance of the institution. IQAC SLS Pune governs under the chairmanship of our Honorable Director and works through a team of internal and external members. Our professors constitute the internal members, and external members include experts from different fields, such as representatives of NGOs, society, management, our industry partners, alumni, and also students. We meet 3 to 4 times a year to discuss our short-term and long-term plans and also the action taken report, and give due recognition to the feedbacks received from our different stakeholders. Through IQAC, the institution is making an attempt to translate to reality the bigger objective of SIU to soon become a world-class university. In pursuance of this target, we continuously make improvements with respect to the curricular aspects, teaching, learning and evaluation, research, consultancy and extension, infrastructure and learning resources, student support and progression, governance, leadership and management, innovation and best practices. Thank you very much.
Now I request Dr. Rupal to highlight more on the impact of Symbiosis Center for Advanced Legal Studies and Research, which she is directing.
Thank you, ma'am. First of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Rupal Raut Desai, Associate Professor at Symbiosis Law School, Pune. I'm currently the deputy in charge for Symbiosis Center for Advanced Legal Studies and Research. I'm also a member of Intellectual Property Cell of Symbiosis International University. I'm in charge along with another colleague of mine who's also a patent attorney. I'm also a patent attorney. We both are also in charge of tech legal cell of Symbiosis Law School, Pune. Today I would like to first of all highlight the impact and the role that is played by Symbiosis Center for Advanced Legal Studies and Research. I will henceforth be addressing the center as CALSAR. The CALSAR was established in 2012 under the leadership of our director, Dr. Shashikala Gurpur, and our deputy director, Dr. Bindu Ronal. Currently, CALSAR is headed by Professor Dr. K. Parmeshwaran, sir. I'm the deputy in charge, and I'm supported by two other colleagues of mine, that is Ujwal Nandekar and Munazir Ahmed. Further, I'm also supported with various other faculty members who play a unique role in terms of achieving the goals of SCALSAR. Now, what is SCALSAR all about? Now, SCALSAR, as the name suggests, is trying to create a research. I mean, we have in fact achieved quite a lot in terms of impact, in terms of research and publications. We want to further enhance the research culture which is already built here in Symbiosis Law School, Pune. Impact of SCALSAR in terms of increase in number of faculty and student publications, as just Dr. Rawat has already mentioned, that the publication impact is seen right from the first year students. Now, the research is integrated into the classroom. Every student of Symbiosis Law School, Pune, whether be undergraduate or postgraduate, is encouraged to participate in national and international research conferences. Further, they are not only encouraged to participate, but also are increasingly mentored to publish these their original research in reputed journals indexed by Elsevier or Thomson Reuters. Further, the impact is seen in terms of the improved infrastructure, like providing online databases, providing spaces, also providing funding to the students to participate in national and international conferences, and also taking care of part of their expenses when they are coming up with publications in renowned journals. In terms of the research projects, students are encouraged and students do participate in various research projects under the guidance of various faculty members. These research projects are aligned with our centers of specialization under SCALSAR. We have 6 centers of specialization, that is Center for Corporate Law, Center for Justice Education, Center for Private Law, Center for Public Law and Governance, Center for Technology and Innovation Laws, Center for Transnational and Global Legal Studies. So these recently, in the last 4 years, we have completed 5 various research projects which were funded by corporates as well as government agencies. The impact of these research projects has been that our recommendations have been accepted by Law Commission of India and various other legislative bodies. Thus, we act as, or the SCALSAR, along with the support of faculty members and students, acts as a think tank for the legal, for the law reform research projects that we undertake. Currently, there are 3 ongoing research projects, one in the area of environmental law, another in the area of common law and continental law, another in the field of private international law, which are headed by various principal investigators and with the support of other faculty members and students. There is a specific budget that is allocated to research, and a lot of importance is given to research right from the undergraduate to the postgraduate and also to the PhD level. SCALSAR organizes various programs, including its highly acclaimed annual research conference, the essay competition, the Indian Legal Thought Essay Competition, various research-related guest lectures and seminars for both faculty members as well as students to further hone their skills in research. Further, SCALSAR also includes the legal aid cell of the Symbiosis Law School, Pune, the Community Legal Care Center. There are 4 facets where the students get to participate in these activities relating to the legal aid and community legal care. First is the educative, where there are awareness programs and campaigns conducted by students under the guidance of faculty members. This is to improve the legal literacy in community, thus fulfilling the developmental goals identified by United Nations. The second facet is participation of students in legal clinics. SLS Pune provides opportunities to students to work in 21 different areas of legal clinics, some of them being prisoners, senior citizens areas, women, law related to women, helping the women and children in and by participating in these legal clinics, where the students get to learn various skills, including interviewing skills and also consultancy skills to provide legal aid and consultancy to the needy and to the poor. Further, there is a great emphasis on using alternative dispute mechanisms, resolution mechanisms such as negotiations, mediations, to resolve the disputes through using these clinics that we organize under the community legal care center. Further, the third facet of this community legal care center is to is research skill and creation of new knowledge. The students conduct surveys in villages across various sections of society, and they also conduct interviews which form the basis of law reform research which leads to creation of new knowledge. The fourth facet is the training and skill development. Programs oriented towards skill development through workshops and training programs are organized regularly for the students of legal aid, and in turn also the faculties are participating in giving paralegal training. We also train the police personnel and various lawyers in enhancing further the knowledge and to achieve the institutional social responsibility goals with the help of students and faculty. The other field or the other function of the SCALSAR is to also encourage the PhD scholars and the LLM research students who continuously are benefited from the SCALSAR activities, as they can participate in annual research conference which is organized every year. They showcase their research. They can also submit their research for publication in two of our flagship journals, that is the Symbiosis Contemporary Law Journal and Symbiosis Student Law Review. They also benefit from intensive research-oriented training with various professors from nationally renowned professors as well as internationally renowned professors who come and train them in advanced research methods. The PhD scholars and the LLM students, the research that is coming out of them, and including also we have consistently seen now our undergraduate students are also making their mark by bringing out very high quality research, original research. The SCALSAR emphasizes on research ethics and the research you can see that they are mainly on contemporary issues and from emerging areas of law. So some of our PhD and LLM scholars, including also other undergraduate students, have published their research, their thesis, their dissertation in various with renowned publishers. So SLS Pune plays an important role in research integration in the courses that are learned, learning, and also provides various research avenues. I thank the thank Director Ma'am for giving me this opportunity to address the aspects of SCALSAR. Thank you, Ma'am.
Thank you, Rupal. Now, Professor Munazir Ahmed will quickly summarize the placement activities. After that, we will start taking up questions.
The entire process for all three activities is throughout the year. Firstly, we screen out the we have a screening process for all the fourth year students who go in their final years before they start with their placements, where we see that the students, if they are lacking in any of the qualities or if they are not understanding what is the perspective of the industry, what they are looking for. So we give them a training, we groom them. Various activities has been conducted in the past, like soft skills, we on writing, on resume writing. We have so many experts coming from the industry who come here and have the session for entire 1 day for all these students. Then after screening, we have then the placement process. The day zero, we start for the fourth years in the month of August, where we call all the companies on a single day, which is we also call it the day zero, where students, they sit for the placements and they choose their companies or the firms according to their choice. Now there have been a lot of placements which we have received the last year, where they have a scope to have an international, which we have received a query regarding where there's a scope of an international placement. So there are firms and the companies who are coming, who are giving opportunities to the students for an international placement. For example, the companies like Ernst & Young, ICICI Bank, we have SDFC, where they recruit students from here, they give a proper training, and after understanding the competency of the student, they place them. So it's not a final placement, but they place a student if they totally give a good feedback during their training, so they are placed abroad also. Last year we also have one company called Radden Partners, where they have taken few students for the international office in Dubai. So scope is always there for the international placements, not in only the few limited countries, but wherever the companies have their offices. And in the structure, we after the placement, we have a placement. So there's 100% placement for all the students or for the placements. So many of the students, they also go for further studies. Some of them, they prepare for judiciary. Some of them, they sit for the civil services exams. So all the students who are interesting before the placement starts, so we make sure the 100% of the placement for all the students before the semester commences. Now, as per the records, last year we have a placement for the students where the highest package was 15 lakh, which ma'am had already talked about, and the average package was calculated yesterday. It was around 8.2 lakhs. So it's not that the entire process comes to an end. We also keep an connection with all our alumni for the future. So once they go to the industry, they learn the industry, they learn the work culture. So for the current students, right from the first year to fifth year, so we keep on calling them back to back again, so that they come and give a kind of a feedback, or a kind of we can say an extra knowledge, that what industries, how they have to work, how they have worked on their entire profile, what subjects they should opt, what industry is looking for the subjects when they do their specializations, or when they have a choice to choose. So placement cells facilitates all these activities from the first year to fifth years. We also provide them internship opportunity with the different organizations, whether they are corporates, whether they are legal firms, whether it's a judiciary. We also provide them a recommendation letter from on the behalf of Symbiosis Law School, which give them a cutting edge over the students coming from the other colleges, and they are likely to be taken into for those internship or summer internship programs. We also have, and it's not an only internship, but we make sure that the internship which are given during the summer to the students, they are also paid a suitable stipend, so that students can at least support themselves where they are, because we have students all over from India. So if a student is coming from Delhi and getting an opportunity to intern in Bombay, so it becomes little difficult for a student to stay there for 1 month. So the companies also provide them a stipend, and we request the company to generate such kind of fund where student can at least support himself or herself to pursue that internship, and no need to struggle to stay in Bombay for that month. So these are the information as of now for the placement cell. If anything, so I'm here only. Thank you.
Which is sort of a lot of life skills which you know, you all are inculcating. And the third, I think, the softer part is, you know, the students have a very balanced lifestyle, you know, a best of both world of a campus and a city life. And I'll briefly touch upon all of these three. You know, I've always been sort of a little concerned with a lot of the other law colleges where the admission process is based on just a three-hour exam and how you perform on the 3 hours. And there is nothing more than that. I think this is one college which I found, you know, which is very nice, where beyond the exam itself, you are, you know, what the college makes the effort to have a process of interview, a group discussion, and really, you know, looking out for students who have the necessary skills to make it to be a successful lawyer. And that's a, you know, very commendable sort of initiative which encourages me to that, you know, that this is, that the college is on the right track. The other thing, as I talked about, is skill development. I've seen, you know, I have seen in my daughter, you know, the way she's developed. So you've heard for the last few minutes that there are multiple opportunities, multiple things which students can do. So the first thing which, you know, which all of us have to manage is time management. So to be able to manage yourself from doing, participating in all the activities which are being offered, and yet, you know, sort of being focused on your education and not, you know, losing out on the fun. So I think they are exposed to time management at a very early age, an important skill. The second thing I think which is very important is, you know, you are enabling them to sort of be articulate. You know, one example which we heard was the whole moot court, you know, and, you know, how you're flying down people to, you know, investing in them to learn how to moot. And that to me is, you know, while, you know, if I sort of dumb it down, it is basically helping them how to be more articulate, how to present well. And I see in my daughter, you know, development that she's, you know, she's getting more articulate, getting to present well, and that's something which whether you are arguing counsel, whether you're corporate counsel, you know, whether you are in law firms, you need to do that, you know, continuously and do it very well, and that sort of makes you stand out from others. And the third, I think, is very, very important is, you know, the whole leadership skill. I mean, I've seen here what the faculty is doing is they are letting the students organize most activities, and they are stepping back and observing to ensure that there is sanity, there is propriety in the whole activity. But students have to go out and organize everything to set up the whole events. You know, successfully, my daughter was involved in successful event, you know, event of having the students, you know, meet, which was there, you know, inter-school students meet. So, I mean, I think these are some of the things which I thought which is important. And the other one which I thought is very distinctive is that here you have a campus, you have a feel of a campus life, the benefit of campus life. Pune is a beautiful, you know, city. I have started, you know, really liking Pune as a city. You are 3 hours away from Bombay, so you have the best of being in Bombay, in Pune, and in the campus. So I think it's a very, very happy and a balanced life. So I think those are some of the things, Dr. Gurpur, I thought were really stands out, and I feel very happy about, you know, what you've done. Thank you for this opportunity.
Thank you, Mr. Sinha. Now I request Dr. Atmaram Shelke to highlight the admission process related queries and some points, and then maybe take up one or two questions.
Thank you, ma'am. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. Webinar of Symbiosis Law School, Pune. I am Dr. Atmaram Shelke. I am in charge, faculty in charge of admission process and Moot Court Association. I am handling admission process along with Professor Tokman, Professor Nagesh Sawan, Mr. Balesh, Mr. Santosh Lokhande, and our AO, Mohini Madam. We are supported and guided by our director, Dr. Shashikala Gurpur, and deputy director, Bindu Ronald. Now I am going to talk to you in brief about skill development programs in Symbiosis Law School Pune and admission process. Now Symbiosis Law School Pune provides institutionalized skill building program. We ensure that every student passing from the portal of Symbiosis Law School Pune acquires at least minimum skills required for any lawyer in the legal profession. These skills normally include skill of argumentation, skill of writing, analytical skill, skills of presentation, and out-of-box thinking, which differentiate a good lawyer from the best lawyer. For that purpose, we conduct regular moot court and mock trial competitions. Apart from competition, we have moot court and mock trial as part of internals. So we ensure that every student conducts or go through the process of at least 5 moot court and 5 internships. Apart from these 5 moot court, we have 3 compulsory moot court as part of fifth year. Now, apart from moot court, we have a special course on drafting, pleading, and convincing, and ADRS, that is Alternative Dispute Resolution System. We take help of lawyers and some of the professors for developing skill in ADRS and DPC, that is drafting, pleading, and convincing. Apart from these regular activities in the Symbiosis Law College, we organize various visits. It includes visit to the college, visit to the Judges Academy, Academy Mumbai, and student gets opportunity to train or get trained from the trainer of the judges also. Now, we also organize the series, lecture series and discussion with none other than Advocate Ram Jethmalani, who is Professor Emeritus of the Symbiosis Law School, Pune. Apart from regular this one activities, we are having various cells and centers that include legal aid cell and legal care center, human rights cell, moot court association, etc., wherein actual or hypothetical problem is created and it is shared with the student, and based on that, deliberation and discussion is done. Now, with respect to admission, we normally get excellent response in term of total number of the admission. If you see the last year, we got 20 to 30% extra admission, but this time we got extraordinary support from the student community, and we got 66% extra application compared to last year. Now, for taking admission in Symbiosis Law School Pune, there are two steps. Step number one, you have to apply for Symbiosis entrance test. For that purpose, you may visit www.sctset-org.in or www.simlaw.ac.in. Now, while applying to SET, that is Symbiosis entrance test, you have to choose Symbiosis Law School Pune, and you have to pay of 1,500 for SET and 1,000 per course for applying Symbiosis Law School Pune. Now, after this application, there is step number two. In the step number two, we have PIVAT, that is personal interaction and writing ability test, that is going to happen from 27th May to 30th May. We call normally 1 to 10 ratio student from the SET examination. So total student called for the PIVAT will be 3,000. Apart from that, we have started LLM and 3-year LLB application also. For that purpose, you can visit www.simlaw.ac.in. Thank you very much. Best of luck, and hope you to see in the Symbiosis Law School, Pune. Over to Director Madam.
Thank you, Dr. Shelke. Now, I'll start answering some of the questions. Did you try to answer any question? Yeah. One question is, somebody has asked, does the course contain any patent law? Is there any future in patent law? Dr. Rupal will take up after I respond to some of the questions. Now, the general question which has been repeatedly asked is, what is the eligibility criteria to appear for Law School Pune? It is a generic eligible criteria explicated by Bar Council of India for law admission all over the country, which is 45% minimum in your qualifying exam, which is 10 plus 2. And those who are appearing and awaiting results of the 12th are also eligible to apply. But at the time of final examination, you have to submit the passing certificate. In case the result is otherwise, then your admission will stand cancelled. What is the fee structure of SLS Pune? We have already clarified it on the in the prospectus and set bulletin. Rupees 2 lakh and 35,000 per year. Out of this, 10,000 goes as a deposit, which you can recover once you finish your fifth year. This is another repeated question. What is the difference between BALLB honours and BBLLB honours? Basically, the difference is only in the basic degree. BALLB students will have humanities related subjects and BBLLB students will have management related subjects. Increasing in number from the first year, or decreasing in number, in the first year they will have more courses of humanities or management depending on BA or BBLLB, and in the third year when they come, there will be one or two papers per semester only related to those, and there will be more papers from law. So it is in a increase decrease kind of way. Law paper is introduced from day one itself. In the first semester itself, you will have two law papers and two ethics papers. So, one ethics, one skill and two law papers. Now, this will increase as you go to third year. In a semester, there will be more than four law papers and there will be one or two subject related papers. So, this is the only difference. As far as legal dimension of the training is concerned, it does not make any difference in terms of choice of career, in terms of competency, in terms of specialization. However, because this is an honors program and because now the curriculum of Bar Council of India gives an opportunity to choose courses from different baskets, it is the student who makes those choices. For example, more courses from the taxation, finance and company law will make a person to go for a corporate kind of career. So it is ultimately your own ability, your choice and the way you click with the opportunity that the placement cell offers or the placement opportunity which may come in your way when you are doing your various internships in terms of pre-placement offers. So ultimately nobody gets placement as a ready-made outcome of any degree. Placement is what individual resources you have developed and you learn on the job and you position yourself to the market. So that is the highlight I would like to give. In terms of summary, I can say graduates in both streams are eligible and have been successful in diverse legal career and opportunities, including corporate positions, lawyering, civil services, advocacy, judiciary, academics, jobs in international organizations, admissions in foreign universities or colleges, bureaucracy, and I can add even politics. So there is no difference as far as outcome of this degree is concerned. Now, another important question that generally the students will ask is which type of questions are asked in law paper. The entrance examination will have 150 questions which are multiple choice questions, 30 each in the following groups: 30 in logical reasoning, 30 in legal reasoning, 30 in analytical reasoning, 30 in reading comprehension where you will be given paragraphs and questions are based on the paragraph, and 30 in general knowledge. Now, after that is the first phase. After, based on the scores there, which usually is, I mean, this time we are going to have anything near about 18,000 as it looks now, minimum 18,000. So 18,000 students will answer these questions. Out of that, 3,000 will be shortlisted for the positions which are available. Now these 3,000, which is 1:10 ratio, these 3,000 will appear in Symbiosis Law School Pune Center for their next phase of selection, which is personal interview based on their curriculum, based on their academic score, based on their communication skill, personality, and writing ability test, which is any contemporary legal topic is given to you and you have to write an essay of about 1,000 words. Now, the second phase determines the final selection. First phase is the elimination phase. Second phase is the determining phase. However, 50% weightage is given to the set score. Therefore, your performance in set is important not only as elimination but also as final selection. Now, because many have asked this question. The next question is, what is the admission procedure for 3 years LLB course? 3 years LLB course advertisement will be out. You will have online registration and payment. Once again, we have people from all over India applying here. Then they will go through the personal interview and writing sample test by arriving in Pune. Can you tell me the placement records of last year? Answer: among those who applied, all 100% got job. Highest salary was 15 lakhs, average salary was 8.20 lakh per annum, which is a little more than what I quoted in my presentation. Now, various avenues of placement and the employers, I had already given you a glimpse on the slide. What is the procedure to get admission to BBA LLB? I scored 77% in class 12. Once again, admission procedure is, right now you register for the set test, because set test deadline is going to expire on the 14th. Once you appear for register for set law test, don't forget to register for the college of choice. We have three colleges. You can apply for all three or any of your choice. One in Pune, which we are now talking to you about, the one in Hyderabad and the one in Noida. You said that you scored 77% in class 12. That's a good score. But it depends on how your competitors score. Your score in your qualifying examination also has got certain weightage in your personal interview scores. Now, there is one question by a parent. My son wanted to do BLLB course. What are the job opportunity to have after completing the course? I repeat, graduates in both streams are eligible for different kinds of legal career and opportunities, including corporate, civil service, litigation, judiciary, academic, jobs in international organization, etc., and admission in foreign universities. Generally, students who tend to do
BA, LLB have got a penchant for public law related careers, which is governance, public administration, or litigation, or judiciary, or civil service, etc. So I would suggest that the selection of the group should be based on the existing competencies, as we have already told in the set bulletin. If you are mathematics averse, then BBA might be a challenge, because we have got two papers. One is the accounts. Accounts has got two papers, and the other is corporate accounting, and we have quantitative techniques. So you have to choose. It is not the legal career which is going to determine your choice. How to get previous year question paper of SLS set? Are question papers available on the website? Papers per se are not available. Sample paper questions are already given in the set website. Now, what is the intake for BBA, LLB and BA, LLB? BBA, LLB is 120, BA, LLB is 180. When is the course going to start? 4th of July 2016. I want to appear for set for BA, LLB. What books should I refer to? There is no specific book for entrance examination which is prescribed by the institute. We cannot also, because it is your aptitude which is tested here. However, there are, I mean, I know that most of you are going to the coaching centers, so they may provide you some sample questions, etc., because they have done the research on this. As the conducting body, it may not be ethical for us to disclose or even to recommend a book. What is the cutoff for SLS Pune? Every year it varies depending on the numbers and the quality of applicants. It's a relative competition. But I must say, going by last few years' figures, the cutoff for BA is higher than cutoff for BBA, and it is usually in the range of 110 to 115 as far as SLS Pune is concerned, out of 150. And we call 1:10 ratio for next level of the process, which is personal interview and writing ability test, as I told you already. There have been number of questions on whether student from Varanasi or student from South India should come to Pune to appear for the next phase in case you are shortlisted. Answer, yes, you have to, because we do not have any other recognized center where we will conduct a interview. Because in the past we used to use our Noida center, now we and Bangalore center, we do not use that anymore since last year. Since we want parents to make use of this opportunity to get a feel of our campus, so we want to do it in Pune itself and nowhere else. What is the rank of Law School Pune? Already my presentation has told you that since 2000 we have been consistently among the top 10. In last 4-5 years we have been either the 4th or the 5th in the most reliable India Today ranking. Recently there is a new ranking body which has emerged, which is ranking most of the professional schools, the GHRDC. There we were ranked second, and in the western region we were ranked first. One more question on procedure and dates of registering for 3-year LLB. Online registration has already been declared and started. Last date for registration is 21st May. Please visit our college website. Is taking admission in hostel compulsory? Answer, no, because official hostel seats are very much limited. They go on the basis of merit. Rest of the hostel seats which are available through Pune's network, college makes available that information. You have to visit, check it for yourself and make the choice. What is the hostel fees? Official hostel fees is including mess and boarding, rupees 1,30,000 per year. And other dwelling places in the region will be touching anywhere near 1,30,000, including all costs. Sometimes it may be 20 to 30% more than that in other private providers. What is the future of cyber law and job opportunity? Answer, generally every lawyer has to be a good lawyer first, and then you specialize in cyber law. And cyber law per se is not a training, it's a specialization, it's an additional skill and knowledge. So firms, banking, cyber security, cyber investigation, cyber forensics, cyber litigation, cyber advisor to the government, private and public sectors, trainer, cyber law, jobs in educational sectors, all cyber related, specialization related jobs in all law firms, because every law firm will require one expert in cyber law because of increasing cross-cutting nature of claims and disputes, which will have a cyber angle, because cyber connectivity and cyber technology have become the lifeline of human transaction. Therefore, it has a limitation and it has a scope, both. Coming to the next question, I am interested in diploma in banking law. Can you tell me admission process fee structure? Diploma admissions are on first come, first serve basis. You have to be either pursuing law in some institution in Symbiosis or some law college in Pune, because it is a taught program, it is not a correspondence program. So attendance is mandatory. And 2 days a week, 4 hours of classes are run, and there is a practical component as well. So it's a little more than an undergraduate course. So it will start in mid-May, and the registration will close by about end of July. Fees is rupees 15,000, including 5,000 rupees deposit. There is one question. I am a science student. Can I take admission in SLS Pune? As far as BA LLB and BBA LLB honors programs are concerned, and all programs in law, you can be pursuing your plus two in any discipline. That's why entrance exam becomes a common, what we call denominator or qualifier to enter the law school selection category. Can I change my specialization at the time of college admission? In any avenue in life, people always appreciate people who are very clear, very well thought, very articulate. So if you are still confused and unsure, that's not a good trait. Briefly put it, in both streams, and all law graduates are eligible in many opportunities, because law has a very close connection to state system and governance. Therefore, corporate careers, civil service, litigation, judiciary, academic, jobs in international organization, admission in foreign universities, etc., are available to law students. Some law students go ahead and do an MBA also. It gives them a better barrage of skills in order to enter the corporate life. Students side by side, when they are studying in a college, have done company secretary, they have done chartered accountancy, and they have thereby increased their market value by enhancing their profile, and these are additional inputs. People have gone through civil service coaching when they are students here as well. Now, in addition to that, specific job opportunities are legal process outsourcing, legal consultation, litigation, jobs in law departments of public sectors, law firms, court managers, jobs in regulatory bodies such as Competition Commission or SEBI, and specific prosecutors and all these government pleaders, even those competitive exams people can answer and get into that. Judiciary, many of our students have entered judiciary by cracking the competitive exam. Is the admission barred by age as a limitation to 3-year LLB course? Can a person from engineering background apply for the course? This is about 3-year LLB course, therefore any graduate can apply. There is no bar on engineering or medical graduate. In fact, we have a medical graduate who is currently pursuing PhD with us. Now, age is not a limitation as far as entrance is concerned. The merit is the limitation. You can compete with the youngsters, and if you are able to keep up to that spirit and expectation, why not? I want to do corporate law in SLS Pune, so do you provide this? Yes, you can opt for BBA LLB to be corporate and law specialist, but if you want to be a corporate law honors, then you can choose a number of courses in your optionals when you move to third and fourth year. We do provide different optionals related to corporate law. What are the qualities required in student to secure promising career in law? Come and join Symbiosis Law School Pune. You will experience how to be successful. To put it in a nutshell, John Hopkins University of USA has listed out these competencies by studying number of lawyers, so also Harvard. So we have picked some of those and we have tested them against the successful law people in India, and we can briefly put it as communication, argumentation, research, analytical skills, out-of-box thinking, writing skills, drafting skills, perseverance, interpersonal skills, team skills, dedication, commitment, ethics, so these are, and hard work. So these are some of the attributes. Next question, is it compulsory to have a good command over English to join law school in Pune? Answer, yes, because As long as in India, English is the medium of communication in Supreme Court and High Court, if you are aiming at high level of law career, then English is the link language. Therefore, you have to have a good command. We also provide additional English courses in an English language teaching institute for students who have such language limitation. What are the extracurricular activities you provide at SLS? Already it has been briefed, and if any one of you has missed, you can go to our website and look for co-curricular and extracurricular activities. To be brief, it includes sports, cultural, law theater, Model United Nations, our festival, essay writing competitions, support for participating in different extracurricular activities. The faculty mentors see that students at least participate in one co-curricular and one extracurricular activity. This is a question from a non-resident Indian. What is the fee for admission under NRI quota for BBA LLB? We say that dollar equivalent of 3,55,000 Indian rupees. We request you to visit the particular website, Symbiosis Center for International Education website, http://scie.ac.in. This will be anyway available for you to read in detail. Last question that is available to me. There are other teachers who are going to answer. My ward completed her 10+2 exam in UAE. Are we eligible to admission in SLS? Answer, yes. But admission is not done through the SET channel. It is done through the SCI channel, which I have already told you. You have to visit the website of Symbiosis Center for International Education. Somebody is asking from Varanasi whether I have to come to Pune for a personal interview and writing ability test. I have already answered, yes, you have to come to Pune. Now, these are the broad questions which I have answered. Then there is one question on LLM. What is the intake for LLM in 6 different specializations, 60 students, 10 in each specialization? Is the fee structure same for all courses? I mean, if you are asking about undergraduate, then it is 2,35,000 per year. If you are asking about 3-year LLB program for the graduate students, it is 1,60,000 rupees per year. If you are asking about postgraduate program, that is LLM, it is rupees 1,10,000 plus 10,000 institutional deposit, that is 1,20,000 for 1 year. I want to know the minimum cutoff for BBA LLB and BA LLB in SLS Pune. Answer, we have already told, it depends on.
Yes, this is a specific question pertaining to patent law. That is, the question is that does the course contain patent law? Any future in patent law? Now, I will answer this question from from our different programs that we carry out, because I don't know whether it's an undergraduate or a postgraduate who's asking the question. So, as far as a 5-year law program is concerned, in the 4th year, in the 7th semester, we have a paper or a course which is an optional course which can be opted either by BA LLB student or a BBA LLB student, which the title of the course is Intellectual Property Law. In that course, we do cover Patent Act, Indian Patent Law 1970. We also introduce to the student perspectives on international law in patent. Further in the semester 8 of the same BA LLB or BBA LLB, the student could opt for another paper that's called Trade in Intellectual Property. Now, this particular paper specifically looks at the practical aspects of patents, trademarks, copyrights, designs, various intellectual property, and also the international perspectives, and with the help of various case studies and practical training, we teach this particular course where a student can be well equipped with patent law, including and also other intellectual property laws. A similar course is also there in the 3-year LLB program. And as far as the LLM course is concerned, then we have a specialization in science, technology, innovation and intellectual property rights, and thus there is a specific paper on patent law practice and procedure, where the practical aspects, the procedural.
Now, in addition to what Dr. Upal told, many a times this question comes about scope for patent law because of the lack of number of litigations in patent field. What the audience will have to understand is, in patent field, it is not just litigation. It's about developing a patent as well. It's about advising right from the beginning. like how Professor Rupal has been facilitating here, our university's IP cell, which operates from the Symbiosis Law School, in terms of identifying ideas, in terms of nurturing them to develop into a patent, and then stand in the market. From lab to market, how do you roll out an idea? These are the different facets where people who are trained by us, like Professor Munazar, we have another professor, Professor Ujjwal, also are contributing, and Professor Amol, who is another patent attorney, contributing along with Dr. Rupal. So you, this has to be viewed. And another thing is the trademark and geographical indications and other areas. See, the current government is talking about using innovation, which is the right thinking. If you look at any country which has developed, it has built on innovation. You look at Japan, look at US. So lawyers play a crucial role as IP lawyers in these areas, in acting as a kind of connector between innovation or science and the regulation. So that role is something to which we prepare you in this law school. I don't know if any other law school can prepare you for that role. There may be many, maybe IIT's law department or innovation-centric IIMs running law courses, but we have a greater advantage to such aspirations because we are located in a city which has got the National Innovation Lab and the National Chemical Laboratories. So, and people like Mashelkar who have been on the lead at the national scenario hail from Pune, and they're available on the think tank of Symbiosis. So that's the advantage that you will see. I hope our team doesn't have any more questions. I hope all of you are satisfied with our queries. If you have any more questions, you are always welcome to ask our different discussion fora. Thank you for your interest in participating here. I thank all the panel members here, my colleagues, and especially parent Mr. Sinha for contributing his valuable input as well as his time. Thank you one and all, and wish you all the best in the upcoming SET law examination.